So Edward Snowden had his big interview with Brian Williams earlier in the week, and the bombshell in it basically was that he said he was a spy. We've got the exact quote for you. "I was trained as a spy in sort of the traditional sense of the word, in that I lived and worked undercover overseas, pretending to work in a job that I'm not, and even being assigned a name that was not mine." Well, National Security Advisor Susan Rice, she doesn't think that's the truth. And she had this to say to Charlie Rose. "He was not trained as a spy. We have no idea where that assertion comes from. And has Edward Snowden done damage? He's done immense damage to the national security of the United States in ways that I wish I could describe in public, but I cannot." I know you love those, Jimmy.
Oh, she can't.
"But indeed, the revelations, that the illegal, unauthorized revelations of Snowden have given our enemies, particularly terrorists, including Al-Qaeda, insights into how we gain information and intelligence on them that have enabled them to change the way they operate and be much more difficult to track. That is just one example." And finally, "Edward Snowden was a contractor working for the NSA and other elements of the intelligence community. Obviously, he's accused of sharing and disclosing illegally some of the most sensitive information of the United States government, allegedly."
Can I just tell you the words that are missing from her statement there? The words, so she always describes Edward Snowden's actions as illegal. She never, she'll say that he's illegally disclosing this information. What she misses is the second illegal. She says his illegally disclosing of the illegal activity of the unconstitutional undermining of our democracy by the people in government that he exposed. She skips all that shit and she just concentrates on the illegal part of Edward Snowden. She completely exonerates her administration, the government, the NSA, James Clapper, lying to Congress. Everybody else who's a lying motherfucker gets a complete pass from Susan Rice, except for Edward Snowden, the patriot who revealed their illegal shit.
Jimmy, in defense of James Clapper, he didn't do it wittingly.
Yes, he's so stupid.
He's such an idiot. He unwittingly did it.
Yeah. Yeah. That's right. So that's what's missing from that statement. All the illegality, she takes no responsibility for what this guy had to do it because you guys are criminals.
Right, and ironically, the administration has changed policies like the metadata stuff. So they've acknowledged that the information that he revealed has been good for America.
Because it's worthy of changing, you know, policy and law. So, so that means that he did do so. Now,
so how do we take
the heart
her?
That's a great question. Well, let's get to the heart of the stuff she's saying about, you know, she can't discuss everything. I understand that. But, you know, what she hinted at here was Al-Qaeda now knows how we gather. You know, they didn't know that before. What if that's true? I mean, I don't know whether to believe Susan Rice or not on any of this stuff, and it doesn't really matter whether I do. She's saying something that's provocative. What do you do with that?
I don't know. Well, that's when we were watching the clip before we started. I don't know who to believe at this point. I genuinely, at this point, don't know whether Snowden is telling the truth, if you listen to everything he said, and whether he was a spy, you know, or a low-level system administrator. And I don't know to believe her, or if he's a double spy. At this point,
I wish Barney Frank were still around, like in Congress, so he could just say, "Yeah, Susan Rice is lying."
Yeah, exactly.
You know? That would be.
So your question is, so let's take her at face value.
Let's say for a moment, as an exercise.
What he did actually did enable the Al-Qaeda in some way. Okay, then that's the
Al-Qaeda. You're going with the Al-Qaeda.
Or Al-Qaeda, the Al-Qaeda.
became an old man
I'm just
there.
Confirming.
The Al-Qaeda, if I want to get proper. Mr. Al-Qaeda.
Mr. Bob Davolina.
What? I forgot what I was saying.
So what do you say?
You say, well, there's this criminal, an unbelievable, massive criminal malfeasance happening inside of our government. If I expose this, it might help some terrorists, maybe somewhere down the line. But I guess the reason why we're fighting the terrorists because they want to change our way of life. But it seems like our way of life has already changed. So I don't know what more damage. So that's what I would go. You have to expose it because the reason why we're fighting the Al-Qaeda is because they want to take away our freedoms. And if our freedoms are already taken away, everyone needs to know that.
Yes, I completely agree. What's the Thomas Jefferson quote before I butcher it? Those who give up
a little bit of their security for a little bit of their freedom for a little bit of their security deserve neither.
Yeah. All right. Well, Susan Rice then doubled down on her comments on CNN.
Finally, on Edward Snowden, he's now saying he was an undercover clandestine officer working as a highly trained spy for the United States. Is that true?
No.
What can you tell us? What was he doing when he was overseas?
Edward Snowden was a contractor working for the NSA and other elements of the intelligence community. Obviously, he is accused of sharing and disclosing illegally some of the most sensitive information of the United States government, allegedly. And our strong view is that rather than give television interviews, he ought to come home and have his day in court, where he will be treated with all the protections and fairness that our judicial system allows.
All right, Jimmy, you made a great point before we started about the day in court. Why doesn't he come back for his day in court?
Why isn't he just coming? Because what happens before he gets his day in court is he gets about 300 days in torture. That's what's going to happen to him. They're going to put him in a cell. They're going to keep him isolated from everybody else for his own security. They'll probably have him naked all day long because he might hang himself. And they're going to wake him up every 10 minutes to make sure he's not killing himself. So that's torture. That's what we did to Manning, Chelsea Manning. That Jose Padilla also tortured. We're torturing people in Guantanamo. So this is the effect when you torture your own citizens, your own military personnel. Other people aren't going to want to turn themselves over to be judged by your criminal justice system, especially if you're the criminals he just exposed you to be. So you can't also be a criminal and then say, hey, come home, we're going to be nice to you now, because you're not. You've been proven to be criminals. You do illegal things, you subvert the Constitution, and all for what? For power, so you can give some more money to Booz Allen? What is this all about? Because the metadata mining, by the way, has saved zero people. They have zero people, zero plots that they've broken up because of this metadata. All they've gotten is $6 billion going to Booz Allen. Okay, so this is again about money. It's obvious she's lying, she's bad at it. And of course, Edward Snowden was all the things he said he did, and that's why he doesn't come home. John Kerry said, why don't you man up and come back to the United States and have your day in court? Well, I say to John Kerry, why don't you man up and prosecute the war criminals that are currently touring the United States giving commencement speeches right now, like Condoleezza Rice and Dick Cheney and George Bush and Donald Rumsfeld, who are self-admitted war criminals. They brag on Sunday morning television about ordering war crimes, and you don't have the cojones to go prosecute them. So how about if you prosecute the war criminals that are walking around freely in the United States, and then you asked Edward Snowden to come home and have his day in court in your torture prison?
I really teed you up for that one.
Yeah, you really did. By the way, the
Secretary of State
doesn't have prosecutorial power, I don't think. I understand your passion. I don't want to diminish your passion on this.
Diminish
issue.
A little bit.
No, it's fine.
Talk to a guy who would be able to.
He knows people.
He knows the attorney general. You know.
He definitely knows.
Kerry has him on speed dial, probably.
You can call Holder. Yeah. He knows Eric Holder.
Listen. You paint the picture that way, and you're absolutely right. And the Snowden case is an exceptional case too. In the past 20 years, we haven't dealt with anything like this. Spying and espionage is a thing of the past. You know, I don't know if he was a spy. I don't even know if he meant that he was like a hired spy.
He said he had an alias. That to me was the part that I thought was...
Well, when you work for the NSA and you are overseas, and I don't know enough about it, but I think that Susan Rice's idea of what a spy is and Edward Snowden's idea of what a spy is might be different. I don't think it matters. I think the point is that this guy cannot come back home. The naivete to say, come back home and have your day in court. He has it on TV every day, and he's not doing well. Don't come home, because you're not going to have a fair hearing, certainly just yet, until somebody comes out and takes their flag off their back and starts saying, this guy did something that's important.
You know, you mentioned the flag on his back. What if during that interview with Brian Williams, I was just praying that Edward Snowden wear a suit coat and put an American flag pin on his lapel?
A little lapel, yeah.
Because then that would ruin it for everybody.
That would be so great.
Everybody, are you a supporter of Edward Snowden? Why are you wearing that? Right. That would have ruined it for everybody. I wish he would have did that.
Yeah, that would have been fantastic. Because also, you know how everyone, when you wear that, you're a patriot until you're Barack Obama. And then I can't believe he's wearing that.
It's a little pandering. It's a little pandering when he does it.
But you know what? I think it's important to make the points that, John, they call him a traitor. They call what he did so bad. But let's remember, what if he was really a traitor, he would have taken that information and give it to a foreign government. He didn't. He gave it to American journalists, and he said, you do what's responsible, and that's what you're supposed to do with that stuff. Yeah. And he did it that way. He didn't sell it. He didn't bring it to Russia with him. And by the way, when he was being interviewed by Brian Williams from Russia, he was critical of the Russian government while he was in Russia. So this Edward Snowden, top to bottom, any way you look at it, he's a quality individual. He's sharp as a tack. He did the right thing, and he's a patriot. And he's exposing John Kerry and Susan Rice and Barack Obama to be the hypocrites who undermine the Constitution. He's exposing them, and that's why they want him to come home, so we can get him in a prison and shut the fuck up, because he keeps exposing us. That's why they want him to come
Santa,
home.
And Santa, by the way, thinks this is a developing story.